Ever need a title, effect, or a transition for your project that you just don't have? Leaving Final Cut Pro and going online to search for what you need can really disrupt your flow. Plus, some of these effect packs can be really pricey. So now, you not only have to leave your project to find what you need, but you also have to decide whether the effect you need is worth the price. This can really kill your flow. And usually, you're not just paying for that one effect you need, you have to buy an entire pack it comes in, which drives the price up even more. It's kind of like back in the day, we used to have to buy an entire album just to listen to that one song we really liked. Sure, once you buy it, you can listen to it as many times as you want, but eventually, you get bored of that song and have to look for something else. That's kind of how I feel about Final Cut Pro plugins sometimes. I own a ton of plugins, but there's always newer, shinier plugins coming out, and I want them too. Now, with the music industry, you know what happened. How many of you go out and buy individual songs or albums anymore? You don't. You probably have Apple Music, Spotify, YouTube Music, or some similar. Well, MotionVFX has just done to plugins what Steve Jobs did to the music industry. This is Design Studio, the latest revolutionary offering from MotionVFX. Design Studio comes in three tiers. You can get Design Studio Essential with over 3,100 motion design elements, Design Studio Professional with even more options, including over 3,600 elements, collections designed with famous YouTubers like MKBHD, iJustine, Peter Lindgren, and more, over 750 trackable elements, and more. And for those that need absolutely everything, Design Studio Ultimate. This includes everything in Design Studio Professional, Cine Studio 2D and 3D, over 400 compositing elements, personal support, and much more. The tier you choose is completely up to you. But even with Design Studio Essential, you will not be disappointed. All three tiers will constantly be updated, so you'll always have access to the newest, shiniest plugins. MotionVFX has also reinvented the way we use plugins in Final Cut Pro. Let's jump in and add a few elements to my project, just so I can show you how intuitive Design Studio is. When you install Design Studio, you won't find anything new in your titles browser, or the effects, even the transitions browsers. That's because instead of being a plugin, Design Studio is a Final Cut Pro extension. When in Final Cut Pro, click the Extensions button in the top left corner and select M Extension. Design Studio opens up in its own floating pop-up window. What I like to do is resize my window so it's always visible on the left-hand side beside my media browser. First thing I want to do in my project is add a subscribe animation at the start of my video. There's a few different ways we can find what we need in Design Studio. For the subscribe animation, I know it's in the M2 or 4 pack, featured right here at the top, so I can just click on it, select the social media theme, find the preset I want, and download either the preset itself, or if there's lots I want to use from here, I can download the entire M2 or 4 pack. I just want the subscribe animation, so I'll download it by itself. Once it's downloaded, we get this drag and drop icon, signaling that this asset is ready for use. Now, all we have to do is drag and drop it above our timeline and adjust it just like any other plugin. A new camera. It's a Lumix S5 Mark IIX and I love it. It has phase detect autofocus. In the next part of my video, I talk about how you can record directly to an SSD drive with a B-roll clip of what I'm talking about. What I'd like to do here is highlight or maybe circle the SSD drive in my clip to draw the viewer's attention to it. I don't know exactly what preset I need for this or what pack it comes in, so let's just search for a circle. Let's check out what we have here as add-ons. Hover over any preset to preview what it's going to look like. I think this is what I want, so once again, let's download it and add it to our timeline. Just like any other plugin, we can use the on-screen controls or the controls in the video inspector to adjust it and make it look exactly the way we want it to. Hey, OpenGate, you can record directly to an external SSD drive. If you really like a preset and want to make it easier to find next time, you can right-click on it and either add it to your favorites or even make your own collection. Let's add this one to a collection. Click the plus button to make a new collection. Give it a name, and click Create. Design Studio comes with a lot of assets, so you're going to want to organize them so it's easy to find your favorites, and Custom Collections is a great way to do this. You can even copy the link for your collection and share it with someone else who has Design Studio. But let's keep going. For the next part, What I'm saying in my project is important, so I want to emphasize it by zooming in on it. Once again, I'll search for zoom, and let's try out a few overlay effects. Once again, just skim over any effect to preview what it's going to look like. I really like this one, and I've used it before, so it's already downloaded. I can tell because when I hover over it, we get this drag and drop icon. Once you download a preset, next time you want to use it, all you have to do is drag and drop it into your timeline. Charge this camera. You get a cord and a power brick. So if you want to charge your battery, you have to put it in. Another way to find presets is to use categories to find what you need. So if we want to add some text, we can just select M elements to search for individual elements and further filter it out to typography. Find a preset you want to use, download it, and add it to your timeline. Super simple and easy to find exactly what you need. So this is Design Studio from MotionVFX.
Now there's one more thing.
If you were paying attention before, when I clicked the extension button in my version of Final Cut Pro, you may have noticed another extension you've never seen before, M Captions. Every tier of Design Studio comes with M Captions, an AI-powered subtitle generator for Final Cut Pro, and it's freaking amazing. All you have to do is record yourself, and M Captions will recognize and accurately generate subtitles in over 90 languages from around the world. Let me show you. Clicking this extensions button opens up M Captions in its own floating Final Cut Pro window. First, skim through and choose one of the over 50 animated caption presets. Once you find the one you like, select your file with the audio to be captioned and simply drop it right here. This can be a video or an audio clip from Finder or even from your media browser in Final Cut Pro. You can do individual clips, or if you want to, you can caption your entire project. Just select it in your media browser and drag and drop it into your captions window into the drop file here box. Sometimes, if you have a really complex project, you might want to export the audio from it and drop that file here, but for most part, dragging your project into M Captions will work just fine. Set your project resolution and frame rate to match your Final Cut Pro project, adjust the appearance of your captions, and once you're ready, click the Analyze Audio button. This might take a couple minutes, but for what it does, M Captions is actually really fast. Once your audio is analyzed, you have a couple options for exporting your captions. You can add the generator captions to a Final Cut Pro library as a separate project. You can export an SRT file to use outside of Final Cut Pro, or you can just select the drag from here option. Just simply click this button and drag your generated captions straight into your timeline. This exports your captions directly into Final Cut Pro as a connected storyline. You can keep it exactly as is, or if you still want to shift any clips around, just select all of them and use a keyboard shortcut Option Command Up arrow to break up this connected storyline. Now, the transcription in M Captions isn't perfect, but it's damn close. I've tried almost every captioning tool out there, and nothing comes even close to the accuracy of M Captions. First of all, it understands me perfectly, and I know I don't speak very clearly. Even when I mumble, 99% of the time, M Captions knows exactly what I'm saying. And second, because this is all AI powered, M Captions knows exactly what I'm talking about in my video. For example, the camera I was talking about was a Lumix S5 Mark IIX. And look how perfect the subtitles picked it up, even transcribing Mark II with Roman numerals. So that's M Captions. Now, let's talk about the elephant in the room. As you probably already guessed, Design Studio is a subscription. If you just came here to complain about that, you probably aren't watching anymore. Whatever, you have every right to dislike subscriptions. I don't like them either, but almost every single plugin in Design Studio is available as a standalone purchase. So if you want to, you can go ahead and buy them outright, and MotionVFX will still support them, same way as they support all plugins that are part of Cine Studio. So you still have that option. But like I mentioned at the start of this video, it's kind of like iTunes and Apple Music. You can still go to iTunes and purchase individual songs and albums, but most of us don't. This is because it doesn't make sense financially. It's much cheaper just to subscribe to Apple Music. Same as Design Studio. If you use Final Cut Pro professionally, and need access to the latest and greatest plugins, a subscription makes much more sense. If it's not for you, or you already own a bunch of MotionVFX plugins, you can still use them, and they'll still be supported by MotionVFX. And if you're just starting out, a monthly fee might be a lot more reasonable than buying all these plugins outright. But you can decide which option is better for you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.